Hello everyone and welcome to NewsClick. Tamil director Pa Ranjith got into controversy over his speech on Emperor Rajaraja Cholan. His comment that suggested Dalits were oppressed under Chola dynasty disturbed a section of people and a case is booked against him. Today we have with us Professor C. Lakshmanan, faculty of Madras Institute of Development Studies and a member of Dalit Intellectuals Collective to discuss about this issue. Welcome, sir.
Welcome. Thank you.
About Pa Ranjith, sir, what is your opinion?
Pa Ranjith is a very very talented director, artist, and also committed political activist, which is a rare compliment in the contemporary Tamil cinema industry. The issue now with Ranjith in the early week of June, he attended a memorial meeting of TM Mani, allies for Umar Farooq. It's a fourth year memorial meeting organized by Neelapuligal Katchi. So in that he was invited and asked to deliver a lecture, speak in the memorial meeting. So Ranjith was prepared enough, collecting the book written by Umar Farooq, TM Mani allies, and that book title I am not recollecting, but you can get it. So based on that book, he spoke three important things. One, during a Chola period, the land from the poor and working class, particularly marginalized, are Dalits being taken away and given to others, particularly the though Ranjith did not say this, but given to the dominant caste. But generally the history, it is a fact in the history, those who are done a great amount of time in terms of writing ancient Tamil history, particularly Nilanda Shastri and Dharma Kumar, who was a professor in Delhi School of Economics, who wrote 1969, Land and Caste, and also Bertenstein, one of the very important historian in the South India. They made a very profound observation that land during Chola period and also other dynasty given to three main category or group. First comes the Brahmins, and where the Brahmodayam, concept of Brahmodayam emerges, it is very much in the fact. Second, the Vellalas, the next to the Brahmin, and they are next to the Brahmin dominant caste. They also got an enormous land from the dynasty and the ruler. And the third is a temple, Hindu temples. And till Tamil Nadu temple owns the highest land than the Tamil Nadu state itself. So then the final fourth is land to the village. Land given to village is a collective endeavor, because land treats came to exist only after colonial state established. Before, there was no land treat, land patta is not there, but it's all in the traditional way of owning land. So Brahmins, non-Brahmin Vellalas and the temple own highest amount of land. And the control of land between given to village and control over land in the village by the temple is totally different. Temple control is, we all know who is controlling the temple. And benefit, if your control is with somebody else, and the benefit also cornered by them. So therefore Ranjith made a statement that Tamil Nadu temples are having a lot of land. And third thing which is also not spoken is the position of women in the ancient time, particularly Chola time, where the Chola kingdom, we have a Devadasi system and so on and so forth. So I am not authority on ancient history or Tamil Nadu history, Chola dynasty. I am a political scientist. Maybe one can call it political history. I have some knowledge. So there is a fact. But if at all Ranjith spoke anything without evidence or anything without out of context, there could be a debate and discussion can be engaged, not in a way of curtailing his one's freedom of expression. Not only Ranjit, anybody for that matter, freedom of expression, freedom of dissent is a core element of or core component of the democracy. Democracy should not be stopped election and election result. Democracy is behind the election, and democracy is a way of life, and democracy it is dissent, and democracy, freedom of expression, liberty, individual liberty, personal liberty, all this is encompassed, embodied in the concept of democracy, and which one has to adhere to. But what happened to Ranjith is a very, very unfortunate, and it should not be happened. And underlining fact which require, Ranjith also spoke, that we need to deconstruct our own understandings. Because generally, Chola being celebrated, Chola dynasty is being celebrated for so many account, no question. But why not Cholas, everybody has a merits and demerits, two sides of the coin. So Ranjith is deconstructing our own public or a common notion of history. Common notion of, he was actually deconstructing the entire public notion or a common understanding of history. So that is a point which is Ranjith is making. And another thing he said, in late 80s, particularly when the identity politics emerges in the beginning, and also even early 19th century also, when the it's a golden period of caste formation, I should say, because every community, every caste, small caste group come together in order to corner the state benefit, colonial state benefit. They make a number high and plea for a certain benefit from the state. Similarly, what happens now, the identity politics in the late 80s, people have trying to construct their own history. When they construct their own history, that were the starting point is, we are descendant of the ruler, descendant of that dynasty, this dynasty. Ultimately, nobody is a subject now. Even among the Dalits, non-Dalits, and others also claim themselves, we are descendant of Chola, descendant of Pandyan, we are big rulers, all these things. So Ranjith is giving a knock that don't claim those nonsensical claim, which is actually is not. So therefore, Ranjith is not attacking one or another particular caste group. He was critical of entire caste group which claims a descendancy from the dynasty or the erstwhile rulers.
Many communities, caste groups, and all these people are coming against Ranjith. Why do you think, you know, they are coming with such an anger towards him?
No, not a community or a particular caste group as such. Anti-Ranjith forces, mainly from the Hindutva brigades or reactionary forces, and second is some of them are from Tamil nationalist, and they are pseudo Tamil nationalist, because they know history nor they know culture. They are one who are very vociferous in terms of against Ranjith, and this also has undercurrent. Because the reason is, Ranjith from the beginning, day one onwards, almost is declared very openly that I am a Dalit. I am come from the oppressed of the oppressed. And I have no shame, and also I have no pride of it. And he was a one who was very vocal in terms of anti-caste project. And also he was a very powerful, internalized Ambedkar ideals and Ambedkar thought. Nobody can challenge Ambedkar, because that is what, wherever he goes, he starts with the Jai Bhim, which is very, very new phenomena. Second thing is, in the film industry, unlike Ranjith, none of other personalities in the film industry able to neither assert themselves as their self nor incorporate the way in which the assertive and positive energy of the community. And also he was asserting himself that is, I am not afraid of anything. And in a way, he is also risking. So that is the people think Dalit should not speak openly, Dalit should not speak truth, Dalits have no intelligence of their own, but that is disproved. And Ranjit during all through he was anti-Hindutva forces, and the Kala was one direct critic on Hindutva forces. And even during election, because he is not stand as isolated himself, he was an activist. He is a very, very powerful activist. He made a lot of initiatives and brought and made it's a meaningful. Take an example of Castles Collective of Madras, the Nativity Music, or Vanam Festival, or even a library initiative in Kugai. And also he was, wherever atrocities happening, neat suicide, he was the one who organized. And violence wherever happens, he goes and he sends his team from the Neelam Panbattu Mayam group, go and intervene. So this never seen in the film industry, a person coming in, participating everyday politics and everyday activities in the society. And he is critical of the state and the central government as well.